Hello from Chem Help ASAP. Let's make an ester. To make an ester, an acid derivative, we start with an acid chloride. Remember that acid chlorides are our strongly electrophilic reagent for accessing almost all the other acid derivatives. So we'll take our acid chloride and react it with an alkoxide. The R prime group of the alkoxide will match the R prime group of our eventual ester product. The alkoxide is a nucleophile. It attacks the carbonyl of the acid chloride. Anytime we attack a carbonyl, we get a tetrahedral intermediate. The big question for a tetrahedral intermediate is, do I have a leaving group? If yes, then we kick it out and reform the carbonyl. So, do we have a leaving group? Yes, a chlorine. We use the O- minus to kick it out and reform the carbonyl. Well, what do you know? In those two quick steps, we have formed an ester. It's that easy. Let's look a bit more at these two quick steps. The first step broke a CO pi bond. It is a nucleophilic addition. The second step makes a CO pi bond. It is some kind of elimination. The net effect of an addition-elimination is a substitution. This reaction performed a substitution. We substituted the OR prime group in place of the Cl of the acid chloride. When people say substitution, it's easy to think SN2. It would be easy to look at this reaction and assume it went through an SN2. We have a leaving group in the starting material, chlorine, and a nucleophile, the alkoxide. Why not an SN2? Well, SN2 reactions only occur on alkyl carbons, sp3 hybridized carbons. The acid chloride carbon is sp2 hybridized. This is not an SN2. Of course, because the carbon is sp2, it is part of a double bond. We are instead set up to perform double bond chemistry. An addition reaction. That starts our addition-elimination sequence for the substitution. To finish, let's do one sample reaction of an ester synthesis. Let's say we want to make the molecule in the lower right, this ester. Let's label our R and R prime groups. R is cyclohexyl, R prime is isopropyl. How do we do this? Well, we know we need an acid chloride as a starting material. The acid chloride would just have our R group. So that's cyclohexyl. The alkoxide R prime group will therefore be isopropyl. The solvent for this alkoxide, isopropoxide, will likely be the conjugate acid of our alkoxide, isopropanol. So we'll put in a sodium ion to counterbalance the charge for the alkoxide, and that's it. That's how we would make our desired ester from an acid chloride. Acid chlorides are reactive, flexible functional groups for making acid derivatives. To make an ester, we treat an acid chloride with an alkoxide. The ester forms through an addition-elimination reaction.